Welcome to the video. We've been going through some extreme intensives, super intensives, and the results have been quite tremendous for me. So much so that I'm a little numb, a little tired. And it's just wow. The wow is just like permeating me. And the insights have been so tremendous that I'm not quite able to put them into words. I could. I don't know if I will or not. It was very strong. Very strong stuff. Let's put it this way. There's going to be an opportunity coming up. As I have said, that June 21st, by the way, congratulations to all of us, a thousand subscribers reached yesterday, June 21st, 2015. This has been my goal all along, at least 1,000 subscribers. So this means that a new chapter is opening up now, right on that very day that I knew was the important day. It reached 1,000. I was so shocked by this. So thank you, everyone, for subscribing, and this is a collective effort here that we're doing to help out everyone. It's tremendous, tremendous, tremendous. So the practices, that the intensives, have been extraordinarily successful, but also somewhat tiring. The breakthroughs have been great. I've said that now there's this one-year cycle going to take place, starting from June 21st, 2015, June 21st, 2016. During this time, by the time we get to June 21st, 2016, the world is going to be quite different, actually. And interestingly enough, I've not been paying attention to any of the news, any of the doom stuff or anything like that, but I started to take a peek at it and realized, wow, everybody is just like totally geeked up about, you know, this second half of 2015, and probably rightfully so. I just met somebody at a store, and they just mentioned, oh, you know, September 2015, you know, asteroid, this and that, and that. Now hearing people, financial collapse, and all this, you know, turmoil. Well, we've been talking about that for years, haven't we? And we say our preparation is spiritual. So we're not going to worry about what exactly happens in particular, because what we're doing is we are completing our spiritual preparation, and we have the tools we need, so we don't need to panic at all. We just need to keep doing what we've been doing and accelerating it. That's all. And these practices that I've been introducing here, such as I don't know anything. I absolutely don't know anything. Now, I don't want to go too fast here, but we're going to have two options. Everyone in the world has two options. I believe this is somewhere along these lines, that there will be those in the world who will, let us say, have the vision of oneness, the vision of Christ, the vision of holiness, the vision of sacredness, the vision of sameness, the dawn of the kingdom of now, and they will... At least I can say that it's possible that they will simply be very quiet and still, like Ramana Maharshi, and sit quietly and be very, you know, be very quiet, peaceful, still, but beyond what we expect. And we'll have the opportunity just to sit with them. And experience the wow of this. There'll be a tremendous wow factor emanating from them. Tremendous wow factor. We won't have to talk. We won't have to have dialogue. No questions answered. It'll be like a silent satsang. This is one possibility I see. And it could be all around the world, actually. That there are those who wake up to the kingdom of now. And we'll start this, and people begin to congregate, and it will grow and grow and grow, grassroots, word of mouth. And that's how I see the positive going. And the other will be going towards dancing, music, festivities, trying to keep their optimism up, like the future's going to be great, where time is about to start, let us, pop up circumstances and all this, it's the goddess stuff. It's the goddess stuff. There'll be other gatherings like that. Okay. And though some will maybe will try to go to both. So maybe it's this, I want this, I want that, but most will settle into what they feel comfortable with. No flowers here, no flowers, no music. No celebrations, no pomp and circumstance, just silent sitting. And then this will be very profound, very profound. The wow, the intensity will be off the charts. This is a possibility over the next year. And those who do the silent sitting, the troubles of the world, they'll realize, wow, I have the tools so that they cannot touch me. Ultimately, we can simply see ourselves as light bodies. People say, well, wow, how do you deal with the body? Should be a piece of cake when you follow this practice, walking together in the wow. At some point you realize it's all a dream. Dynamics in a dream, producing other stuff in a dream. The dreamer is not bound by those dynamics at all. Not at all. Not at all. Not in the slightest bit. And once we realize this, it's, oh, sure, we can just have the body appear as light bodies if we want. Or even flesh bodies that aren't bothered by anything, don't have any needs at all. It's very, very possible to reach this and accept this. So we will have this, there's likely that to be this, two different types of situations. We're not going to mix the two up at all. Absolutely not. I've been there, done that, already seen what that's like, and that's not where it's at all. Now, when we're talking about there's absolutely no remedy. There's absolutely no remedy whatsoever. Okay? I don't have any remedy whatsoever. I don't have any remedy whatsoever. Okay, what is this talking about? Okay, let's be clear about this. It's talking about that we don't. There's no way to have arrogance, and without fear, it's impossible. Okay, whereas what I call the Eve deception is the belief that we can have arrogance without the fear. There's a way to get rid of the fear, which ultimately is we're trying to create a kingdom of time, which we will then present to arrogance and say, look. We created a kingdom for you, but you're the God now of this kingdom, and we believe, this will take away the fear of arrogance. There's no, it's all our imagination. You see, we told arrogance, or we told ourselves, which is arrogance, we told ourselves that we are the new prime creator. And then this is arrogance, that we can change what God created. But arrogance knows it did not create itself. So we're telling arrogance, hey, arrogance, you're God, you're the greatest. But arrogance deep down says, wait a minute, I feel like I'm just a projection. I don't feel like I created myself. So it's arrogance is totally insecure. Totally insecure. It's an insecure fake God that we're trying to create. We cannot create God, you see. But we can certainly entertain the arrogance. But arrogance is totally insecure. So we're trying to find a way to get rid of this terrible insecurity that arrogance has and the terrible fear that it has and how that fear plays out. And we're trying to present a kingdom to it and say, look, see, you are God. This is your kingdom. And so there are those who believe that this can be done, and they're working on it. This is what I call the Eve deception, Adam and Eve sort of thing. Sort of it's an allegory about this whole thing, is spirit saying, no, we can find a way. Ultimately, the way is what? Flesh, the kingdom of time. And the belief in bodies and all of this time, space, process, and form. So though there are those who are still believing that there's a way to have arrogance and not have insecurity, for arrogance to not be insecure. Now, what Jesus points out to us is that this is impossible. A Course in Miracles does a great job of pointing out that this is impossible. And when we realize this, we say, oh my gosh. All this time I've been, believing that maybe there's some way to do this and getting caught up in that. And then we realize there is no way. This is what happened this morning. I realized there is no way. I don't have any remedy whatsoever. I have no remedy whatsoever. We're speaking to all these efforts, this belief that there is a remedy, and we can find it. We have to find it. And there'll be some way to start this kingdom of time, and the kingdom of time will become a real kingdom. And then arrogance will say, oh, I really am the God, the prime creator. Because why? Here's the evidence. Here's my kingdom, you see. So this is what we're saying. No, this can never happen. I don't have any remedy. I don't know how to do anything. In other words, I don't know how to cure the insecurity of arrogance. It's impossible. You can't have your cake and eat it too. We cannot have arrogance without this terrible feeling of insecurity, because we're the ones who just imagined that we could create a new God. And that's all it is arrogance. We cannot create a new God at all. There's no truth to it whatsoever. And so arrogance looks at us and says, who are you? You know, and says, and we say, oh, well, you created us. And arrogance says, huh? Well, who created me? You know, deep down, arrogance feels like we're very threatening to it, because it feels like maybe we created it. You know, it can't seem to get rid of that threat. It thinks that we can destroy it. So it really wants to destroy us, you know. So we created this Frankenstein, but it's just a projection. Arrogance is just a projection, and we can set it down. We can set down this nonsense through this practice. As Jesus says, you need to let go of your valuing everything you think you want. Leave a clear space in your mind, and the vision of Christ will come into that clear space in your mind. And I believe what he says is true. So this is what I've been doing and sharing. These practices are very potent practices. Let going all your valuing. I don't have any remedy whatsoever. I have absolutely no remedy whatsoever. And the more you do these practices, the more you let go of this Eve deception. I've pointed out many, many times that there's this massive shift in the culture of the world where this Eve deception has come very, very strong now. And basically, there's all these Eve cheerleaders saying, you know, cheerleaders of the Eve deception saying, you know, yes, we can. We can get this kingdom of time started, and then we'll give that to arrogance, and arrogance will be happy, and then we'll have this perfect millennium, because finally arrogance will no longer be insecure. So this is what's really taking place in this world. As you look upon the world, is this belief that there's a way to finally satisfy arrogance. And we think once it's satisfied, no more insecurity, no more fear, no more attack. We'll live in like peace and love and happiness in this millennial age, and everything will be wonderful. So you have all these troubadours, you know, playing their guitars, and all these glamorous cheerleader info babes there, you know, saying, come on, you know, just saying, hosting everything, you know. It's just amazing. You cannot turn on anything now where there isn't this glamorous Eve cheerleader hosting the program. It's just like overnight, it's just the most amazing thing. Even the U.S. Open Golf Channel, after every guy finishes his round, there's this glamorous Eve babe there in the studio, and then she's there hosting and asking all these questions, and she's in control of the whole situation. You know, it's just like, what? it is absolutely everywhere. By design. This is what, you know, just look right in front of your eyes. This is what is really going on, okay? And this behind it is this belief we finally are going to be able to satisfy arrogance and give it what it really wants to feel, so it can feel that really is God. You know, it really is the prime creator. And then, of course, we can say, aha, see, we created God. See, that's the agenda behind it is so spirit can say, you see, we are the ones that created God. Here's arrogance with its kingdom and its God, and yet we know that we created it, so we're greater than God. You know, this is our game that we're playing. So I saw all this in very, very powerful ways and clear ways, and it was quite stunning, quite stunning. And I woke up this morning, going around this morning, I was just like, just wow. The wow was so powerful. And I understood what's really going on here, is this whole false notion that we can we can give arrogance what it wants, what it needs, so that it's no longer is fearful or insecure, which is, of course, possible. Arrogance is just our nonsensical belief that we can change reality, which we cannot at all. So, and there's no such thing as time. We cannot give it the kingdom of time. There's no such thing ever. It will just be still our own projections, our own imagination. So Jesus knows this very, very well. And these practices help us clear out and produce this empty space that the vision of Christ can come into that space and show us its new purpose for the dream. The purpose of this beautiful, beautiful oneness, divine oneness, no judgment, upon it. And this is a different purpose. It's the dawning of the kingdom of now. It's not the same thing as the millennium that the Eve deception is planning for. No, it is not that. It's different, very much. So, there may be, all these big concerts and stuff going on around the world, trying to, pray for world peace and all this stuff, kind of stuff like that. It's very likely there'll be a lot of very intense stuff taking place. Musicians will come out of the woodwork trying to do their thing. But for us, sit quietly. No musicians, no music, no dancers, no flowers, no pomp or pageantry. Just simple, severely modest, sitting quietly and allowing this empty space within us to be cleared out of all the things we think we want, these things that we think that will satisfy arrogance, right? We don't need them. I don't have anything. I have absolutely nothing. I have no remedy whatsoever. There's absolutely nothing that I can do. I don't need to do anything, and there's nothing I can do, meaning I cannot satisfy the insecurity. I cannot take away the insecurity of arrogance. It's impossible. Completely impossible. So there's absolutely nothing I can do. Because these practices, again, are related to our previous efforts of trying to think, how can we take away the insecurity of arrogance, the fear of arrogance? And now we're saying, we cannot do it. It's impossible. And so then we let go of all those efforts, all those things, everything we are trying to do to satisfy the appetite of arrogance. And this leaves this open space within us for the vision of Christ to come into us. It's very simple. People are going to be, everyone, spirits are going to be looking for an answer, one way or the other. Either to desperately try and satisfy arrogance once and for all, or to exchange arrogance for the grace of God, for the vision of Christ. It's going to be either one or the other. Don't worry about, how will this happen so quickly? It can happen very quickly. When people truly get desperate, then they can, like that, they just decide, hey, I need to get with this. There's no more fooling around here. The goal that people are looking for is this, clearing out all this valuing of what we thought was valuable to satisfy arrogance. And we realize there's no way to satisfy it. There's absolutely nothing I can do. I don't have any remedy whatsoever. I have no solution. I have no solution whatsoever. Rest in that. And this is very powerful. This protects you from the Eve deception, which insists that we do have a solution. Okay? This is the fundamental difference between Jesus and the goddess or the Eve deception. Fundamental difference. Very, very basic fundamental difference. Jesus is saying there is no way. Okay, and the Eve deception saying, oh, yes, I know a way. I'm smarter than Jesus. I can please, somehow I can find a way to please arrogance. And Jesus says, no, there is no way. There is no way. So, I know there is no way. I know there is no solution. I don't have any solution. I don't have any way. Now, put this in the right context, and you will realize that you are practicing very profoundly. And you may have thought that you'd never be able to do this, but you realize, oh my gosh, I am. And this is the wow factor that I've been speaking about. And we need to get up to speed on the wow factor, because when you realize you're doing profound, high spiritual practice, then you know you're going to feel wow. It's quite shocking, because I wasn't quite sure if I'd ever be able to do this. You know, I'm being shocked by it right now, actually. So, but again, in the right context, you can ride the wave out and just say, okay, this is great. And it's necessary right now. We don't want to get caught up in the eve of deception. And when you see this, you'll say, oh, wow, everything's become very, very clear. This is what we've been doing. We've been rehearsing, dressing, rehearsing, trying to figure out, you know, how to please arrogance and role-playing it, male and female, role-playing that out. And the male has often been cast in the role of arrogance, and the female is cast in the role of Eve, of finding a way to please arrogance, you know. We've just been working on this, you see. All this dream, we've just been trying to figure out how can we see. We can't be the creator of God until God feels like God is God, and so we're trying to figure a way for arrogance to accept that it's God, you know. And so this has been played out in these roles. We've been playing male and female roles, and the male is this angry, insecure, you know, wrathful, arrogant, you know, bombastic, and you know, Eve is this gentle, kind, you know, weak, but she finds a way to calm the savage beast, you know. And she says, see, look, I can please arrogance. I can give arrogance what arrogance wants. You know, we've been playing these silly games for so long, and then Jesus comes on the scene and says, hey, no, doesn't work. Well, of course, we're so caught up in the Eve deception that, you know, we take exception to that. Say, what do you mean, Jesus? We've been role-playing this and doing this dress rehearsal. And Jesus says, no, fundamentally, there's been no possibility it could ever work from the very beginning. You have to set arrogance aside. You have to set the idea of trying to be greater than God. You have to set that down to exchange it for the kingdom of now. And accept what is the vision. You accept the vision of oneness. That's the only way. And so the world, the Eve deception, will continue to play out this dress rehearsal, and the institutions of the world, you know, will seem to be arrogant, and then somehow they will seem to tame them, you know, bring them under control, and people say, oh my gosh, you see, it's possible. But it all, the turmoil could also happen very strongly. So it's a most amazing time, really, to be here right now. But those who have listened to Jesus are not fooled. They're not fooled. Who've truly listened to it in great depth, they understand it is not possible. So it is not possible. Yes, I don't have any possibility whatsoever. I don't see any possibility whatsoever. There is no possibility whatsoever. I have no remedy. I have no solution. There is no solution. There is no remedy. There is no solution. There is no remedy. And we say this with a very positive outlook, realizing this is fantastic to say this, because this empties us out of all these false strategies we've been trying to do to accomplish the impossible. See, There is no way to accomplish the impossible. You can't seduce the impossible and claim that there's a way to do it. It's not possible. So there is no way to accomplish the impossible. All efforts to do so are equally invalid, meaningless, aimless. There's no reason to judge among any of these efforts at all. They're all equally aimless and futile. So why exercise any? We don't need to judge. That's why we can be silent. The final judgment is that there's nothing to judge. That's the final judgment. There's nothing to judge. Nothing ever happened. Nothing ever happened. What do we need to judge happenings for? Keep in mind that the future is just history. When we look at history, nothing's ever happened. Well, the future is just history waiting to happen, right? It'll all be history at some point too, won't it? And if there's nothing to see in history at all, really, then there's nothing to see in the future either. So if you realize the past is nothing ever happened in the past, that means nothing will ever happen in the future either. Because remember, at some point, that the past was at some point still the future until it's actually, turned into what we say, what we experience it now is the past, right? So the future is nothing but the past. It's the same. It's the same. It's just the past that we haven't yet struggled with, So there's nothing. There's absolutely nothing there. Nothing has ever happened. It's just all the past, actually. Meaning all failures, all futility. Just keep in mind that right now, tomorrow, this will be the past. We'll look at it and say, that's the past. And we're looking at the tomorrow, so that's the future. But 2 days from now, what we're seeing as the future will also be the past. You see, so really, it's all the past. It's already the past. It's already aimless. It's already aimless. Meaningless. There's absolutely nothing that I can do. There's absolutely nothing that I can do. I have no remedy whatsoever. Just abide in that in a positive light, because that is great. This produces this. I'm feeling this very strong reaction to this. That's what I felt this morning too. I have no remedy whatsoever. It was very powerful. Yeah, my pulse is beating stronger. This is extremely powerful tool. I have no remedy. I have no remedy. Now, to those who are on the path of salvation, repentance, and redemption, they will rejoice in this, right? They say, finally, I've admitted there isn't any way to do it. And so I'm free of it then. I can get free of it that way. I won't keep struggling, trying to do the impossible. I say, no, it's impossible. I have no remedy. So I cannot create God. I can only flounder in this fear. It's terrible fear. That's it. I don't want that. So let me set down this whole stupid idea of trying to be greater than God by creating God. So it'll be a very positive thing to say. I have no remedy whatsoever. Whereas those who are following the Eve deception, they find this horrible. They find it terrible to say such a thing. How could dare you say such a thing? No. Yes, we can. Yes, we can. We can find a remedy. In fact, we've got one. It's just everybody has to get on the same page. Oh, we've got one. Yeah, we've got it. And all these glamour babes saying, "Hey, we've got it, everybody. We've got it." And you just got to believe us. So it's an anathema to them. You see. So you see, the parting of the ways between these two ways: the way of Jesus and the way of the Eve deception. Very clear delineation of parting ways, because we're practicing and saying, no, I don't have any solution. There is no solution. I have absolutely no solution whatsoever. I have absolutely no remedy whatsoever. Remedies are completely impossible. Solutions are completely impossible. See, in practicing in this way, those who are going along with the Eve deception, they cannot do that. They cannot practice this way. They will, whoa. No, I'm out of here. So there will be this parting of the destiny paths, most definitely. Which is great, which is fine, yeah. We're tired of you know, being dragged along by this Eve deception. So I saw all this in stunning clarity this morning, and said, "Yeah, that's true, absolutely true. Wow." Now this need not separate, these destiny paths need not separate on quote unquote gender at all, not at all. Just because someone's a woman doesn't mean they have to accept the Eve deception at all. No, I don't mean is a woman. I mean the spirit is identifying with a female monkey suit, you know. You don't have to identify with the Eve deception at all. You say, no, 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 no. There is no remedy. I don't have any remedy whatsoever. There's absolutely nothing I can do. There's absolutely nothing I can do. I don't know anything. I don't know any way whatsoever. There is no way. And men don't have to buy into the Eve deception at all, though great many have, because the cheerleaders are very glamorous looking, and they think, wow, you know, they're telling me there's a way, and they're you know, so bubbly about it, you know, it's like maybe there is, and we don't, men, you don't have to follow this nonsense, okay, just because it seems to be a bunch of tinsel and glamour around the cheerleaders, you know. It just actually is quite repulsive. All Eve deception is very repulsive, actually. If you see it for what it is, it's just wow. And they, you know, they try to put a very good face on it, a very peaceful, kind face on it, and say, look, you see, I'll be able to calm down arrogance. There's a way to calm arrogance down. No, there isn't any such way. There's no such way. There is no way. So we don't calm arrogance down. We set it down. Big difference. We give up our madcap adventure of trying to be greater than God. We repent, in other words, we repent. That's very different than, you know, making illusions real and then calming them down or whatever, and then getting rid of them or whatever. Just make, no, different paths, different. You know, one works, the other doesn't. So, we have this fabulous ways of very potent practice. There is no way. I have no way whatsoever. And this is just sends shockwaves through our old expectations of the Eve deception, which we have been engaged in. Men and women have been engaged in this Eve deception for a, you know, tremendous period of effort. And this sends shockwaves through it, shockwaves. And you're able to begin to detach from it. This practice helps us detach from it. I say it's the end of the church age. About a month ago, I talked about the Pope and his shocking statement. And when I heard this, I said, okay, it's on. This, the whole thing's real. Okay, let's go. Because the Pope completely reversed things and said it wasn't Eve, quote-unquote Eve, which is not really talking about women or men so much. It's a spiritual sort. He said, no, Eve wasn't to blame. It was Adam. It was Adam to blame for blaming Eve. Eve was blameless. You know, I said, whoa. In other words, he's saying the Eve deception is the right way to go. And then later, about a month later, here he comes out with, you know, saying that we all need to work really hard to make this world, you know, a beautiful place, or else the world's going to collapse. And becoming, you know, total Eve agenda. He came out of the closet. The Pope came out of the closet. A lot of us realized that he was never, for some of us, he was never in the closet, actually. And we knew he was the last pope and would bring destruction upon the church for sure. And out of this is happening. The Catholic Church has been taken over by the Eve forces to a large extent. Actually, the Eve deception has triumphed at this point in the church. This has been going on for quite some time, and they don't really are not listening to Jesus anymore. Not really. They're listening to Mother Mary, Guadalupe, Mother Virgin of Guadalupe. Like I said, our priest, when he got up to say, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come," he said, "Hail Mary," he started his Marian prayer. He was praying to Mary up on the altar. He wasn't praying to our Heavenly Father, wasn't referencing Jesus. You know, it was like, wow. And then I had experience with him yesterday, and we were in this line, and we were greeting him, and I was next in line. I was there, and this lady was in front of me, and he was talking with her, and oh, wonderful, and so, it was just like he was so taken by this lady, and then she started to leave a little bit, and he turned towards her, and he kept relating with her, and I was sitting there waiting for him, and he had completely turned his head away from me, and then was not even aware I was there, and I said, wow, you know, look at this, and this went on and on and on, and I said, wow, I should just leave. But no, I said, let me see how this plays out. So I just was quietly, patiently waiting. And he went on and on with this lady, how wonderful you are. You know, and the lady was tears, and she had all makeup on, all pretty, like, oh, you know, like this goddess. And you could tell he had to relate to her and not to me. Here's this peaceful, quiet guy. I was in a very peaceful mood. Most peaceful mood of my life. It's a profound quiet in my mind, you know, and I just wanted to wish him the best and all this, and he finally turned to me. I guess he was hoping I just would go away, you know. I guess he could feel it. Oh no, I want to relate to Mary. I want to relate to Eve, the Eve deception. We can make this world a wonderful place. We can make everyone happy. We can ultimately satisfy arrogance. There's some way to satisfy arrogance. We'll find a way. And I was there to tell him, no. There is no way. There is no way to do it. There is no way to do it. And he didn't want to hear it, you know. It was quite amazing. But finally I was able to relate with him just a little bit. I hope it helps. He's a very good priest. But like many, this Eve deception is very powerful. It's the pagan goddess Eve deception, which is taken over the world right now to a large extent. And the Pope is you know, one of the head cheerleaders right now, as is the POTUS, President of the United States. Those are some of the head cheerleaders. There's many, many cheerleaders. The news media, etc., the entertainment industry, all of that. And society in general has gone that way. But I'll tell you this, Jesus has not gone that way at all, okay? Keep that in mind. He is not confused about the impossibility of pleasing arrogance. It's impossible. That's a dead end. It's a dead end road. And we keep being deceived by this. The e-deception is the man and woman thing where, as I said, the woman says, well, you're so arrogant, but look how I can please you and calm you. Now you're so satisfied and, you know, you relax and you're no longer arrogant. And so and then we see, you see, just like this, we can please arrogance, this arrogant God. We can find a way to please this arrogant God, then we can all live in happiness. You know, sex, drugs, and rock and roll is the antidote to, you know, find a way to please arrogance. And Jesus tells us there's absolutely no possibility of this whatsoever. This is total nonsense, total self-deception. So the church age has come to an end, as I predicted it would. It has come to an end. and everybody is trying to make their final determination now of which way they're going to go. Again, you cannot calm arrogance down. You cannot be the nice Eve to arrogance, saying, "Oh, I have a way to please you and make you happy." It's impossible. Arrogance is inherently completely insecure. Completely insecure. Because it's based on absolutely nothing, nothing whatsoever. We can't change God at all. It's impossible. So the belief that we can change God is meaningless and aimless. It's nothing. It's a house of cards. Nothing is really supporting it at all. It has no real support at all. And any attempts, we keep trying to feed this moloch of, arrogance, and it's never enough. It's never enough. It's never enough. It's never enough. It never works. With Eve, deception is always saying, "Oh no, we can throw some more ornaments on and some more makeup on, and dress a certain way." And arrogance will finally say, "Oh, you're the one I was looking for. Oh, finally, my lost love, here it is. I'm so happy now. I'm happy." That can never happen. That can never happen. So we don't need to keep playing these silly games, with bodies at all. It's ridiculous. Just let the body be light. Just let all bodies be light. No more special relationships. None of this silliness, games. Let the body be light. I'm not saying anyone needs to do anything as far as leaving someone or whatever. No. Just let all bodies be light, just where you are right now. No more games, you see? No more games. That's the beauty of it. No more games at all. We have to give up just let go of all this nonsense where the women looking up to men thinking, "Oh, you represent the great arrogant God, and how can I please you?" And men have to stop looking at the women thinking, "Oh, you're the beautiful Eve who's going to be able to calm the God. If I just worship you, I can convince you that you can do it." You say, "Look, you cured my arrogance. You can cure God's arrogance too." This is all absolute silliness. This whole silliness of the relationships that we've had in this dream simulation. It's just nonsense. Let us simply just let all bodies just be light. Let all bodies just be this quiet, still light. That's it. That's it. Nothing more. Let all bodies just be this quiet, still light. And ultimately, by letting go of valuing all bodies, this is what cleans out the space where the vision of Christ can then come into this space. So, the way to prepare is to keep letting go of our values, keep practicing what we value in terms of what we think will satisfy arrogance. There's nothing that will satisfy arrogance. I don't have anything of value. Say, I don't have anything of value whatsoever. Meaning, in relationship to arrogance, there's nothing that works. So how can I have something that's valuable in that context at all? I can't. It's impossible. So I don't have anything of value. I don't have anything of any value whatsoever. I have no remedy. I have no plan. I have no solution. The Eve deception might say, oh my gosh, I need to inspire you more. I'm not inspirational. I need to inspire you so you come up with a plan, a solution, a remedy. Now that's wickedness. You know, trying to inspire someone to do the impossible is wickedness. Okay, that's not love at all. That's terrible. And so we just practice it. I don't have any solution at all. And then embrace that and accept it. Wow, I don't have any plan. I don't have any remedy. I don't have any solution. There's nothing I can do. I don't know any way. I don't know anything. I don't want anything. I don't want anything whatsoever. And I don't want anything at all. Meaning I don't want to pick up anything I believe is valuable in relation to trying to satisfy arrogance, because it has no value. It won't work. So I don't want anything. Now you might be asking, well, how can we possibly be this advanced? This is very advanced. Well, almost 40 years of intense effort listening to Jesus is how we're so advanced right now. At least we're in the ballpark, you know, in the ballpark here. You may have not done this much work, but your role may be to participate in this and be in the ballpark, yeah, and share the experience. Like it's those who go to like a baseball game, they go in the ballpark and they experience it, and they come out and they realize, wow, you know, we have this experience in this ballpark. And those who are outside, they cannot relate to what we experienced in there. Just it's really has quite a different ambience than the people on driving on the freeway, driving past the park. So if you're in the ballpark, you're going to have, you know, you're going to get the experience. I don't want anything. There's nothing that I want. So rather than obsess about the doom, what we should do is take refuge in this practice. Is keep shedding your valuing. Keep shedding your value in this world. This world offers me nothing that I want. Because really we made this world to try and satisfy arrogance. And it's impossible. So we don't want this world. There's no value to us whatsoever. Now we can give it a different purpose. The dawning of the kingdom now. But first we have to let go of the value that we have held for it. Let that go, so then vision of oneness can dawn upon us. Vision of nowness can dawn upon us. So this world holds nothing that I want. This world holds absolutely nothing that I want. We're not going to make this video too long, even though I seem to be waking up a little bit from my stupor of the day as I reached a low point. But these videos are so intense that I just want to keep the momentum going, let you know everything's fine, everything's going great. We're right on track. And don't, no reason to freak out. You can sit quietly, right? If you can sit quietly, you can get in, be in the ballpark, and just start experiencing this. Wow, I really can let go of what is valueless. Stop valuing the valueless. I really can. We have the tools to do it, and we'll be able to do it. It's not as difficult as I thought it was. You see, you may be way more advanced than you think you are. You may be farther along than you think you are, actually. There's absolutely nothing that I want. So, it's easy. You can just sit. Absolutely, it's easy. You don't have to think, ask question, what question I need to ask. Okay, no, just sit quietly and feel this, and you can practice too. Like, there's nothing that I want. I don't know anything. There's absolutely nothing that I can do. I don't have any plan. I don't have any remedy. I don't know anything. I don't have... There's nothing that I want at all. This world holds no value whatsoever. People, I'm not going to extend the video and much longer, actually. I can, again, just letting you know everything's going great. Everything's going great. It's all going great. Today is what, the 22nd? Yeah, 22nd of June. So we're underway in this 1 year period right now. So we're just rolling out, what the best we can do, rolling out what's going on here. And we reached, like I said, 1,000 subscribers, which was very, yesterday was a huge day for me. It was just enormous. We say go big or go home. So every day you should have something really big, really big every day. Make sure every day it's huge, it's huge. And yesterday was just mega huge. In so many ways, and then reaching 1,000 subscribers like that, it's just jumped from like 993 to 1,000 suddenly. I don't know what happened. It's just, I was just stunned by it, because that's the number. And I said, when I hit that number, then this whole thing's going to roll out somehow. And we hit that number right on the date that it needed to start rolling out. So that is not coincidence. It's impossible to be coincidence. And so just let the wow sink in, just so I can realize, hey, I'm doing great. And it, sometimes the wow's so strong that we think, oh, what's wrong with me? I can't go on. I guess I'm failing. No. It's just the shock of the wow. Always remember, the shock of the wow can mimic failure for you. But don't be deceived by that. Do not be deceived by that. So I need to do this video tonight just to keep reminding myself, yes, everything's fine. It's just I'm so almost overwhelmed by success that I just feel like, oh gosh, this is just amazing. I don't know. So very great. So continue to go big every day, every day, every day, every day. You can do it. You can do it. It's been for me. It's been every day for, you know, is for quite some time. It's big, big, huge, huge, huge. Just tremendous, 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 tremendous lead up to now this 1 year period where it's going to get wonderful. Absolutely wonderful. Okay. Very great. That's it.